What is up, y'all? It's OG here, and it's my first commentary, so let's get it poppin'. We're doing a realistic rebuild series on Cleveland Browns. I'm probably doing it for the Marlins when the show comes out, and NCAA, man, we're probably gonna do some of those too. Let's be honest here, the Browns need to redo everything, so we're gonna get a new owner going here, and see what the name I used was. I used Dr. Shrimp Puerto Rico. Give me a thumbs up if you actually know what that's from. Yeah, man. The 0-16 parade. We're trying to take it from there to, you know, Super Bowl champ. You know, however long it takes. So it's gonna be an interesting time. Personally, I think that 0-16 parade was hilarious. I mean, if you're a Browns fan, I mean, dude, you gotta have some fun with the struggle, man. I'm a Pirates fan. I embrace the suck, you know. Same concept, right? But yeah, man. Starting point. Well, not yet. I plan on Madden, you know, so we're not gonna fuck around or anything like that. Yeah, I want to force lose this whole season, the whole 2017 season. Not in the video or anything like that. We're just going to force loss and, kind of start the rebuilding process. And then preseason wise, you know, we're going to flip just about everybody. Anybody worth value? And the whole plan is to build up picks, as many picks as we can get. That's what we're gonna try to do. It's in the rebuild with the youth movement. It's kind of, and it's great because later on I have a total Cleveland Browns draft movement. Later on, blue draft and a quarterback. A teaser right there. You see, right now, just going through. Look for, I think we're about to trade Joe Thomas. I think it's been a while since I recorded this. Really definitely should have recorded this while I was playing it. That would have made a lot more sense. Let's see here. I think most everybody's about to get flipped. Speaking of the Browns, y'all see Johnny Manziel about to make that comeback. He's got his clothing line just dropped, you know. Go shout out to comeback season. Go check that out on check his Instagram, man. Plug the links on his Instagram and check it out. Support the homie. He's trying to, you know, better his life, and I respect that to the fullest. Yeah, man. See, welcome to the channel. St. Louis, still in school. Play a lot of video games, man, so went and tried to find maybe make a buck or two. So, you know, I am thoroughly broke, as is par for the college life. Yeah. First one, a little awkward. Let's see here, what are we talking about? Side note, how about the fucking Jaguars beating the damn Steelers in the division round? I don't think anyone saw that shit coming. Big Ben played his dick off, though, man. Ben played ball. Oh, man, if you ask me, the Steelers season was over as soon as Shazier hurt his back. And their whole defense is built around him being athletic. Side note, Jabril Peppers is number 27 here, and I didn't realize this. I started playing games the next year, and I already had a 22 on my roster, so I didn't change it. But, yeah. Steelers defense went through shit when Shazier was hurt. That's just, you can't replace him. He's just way too damn good. Alright, looking trades. We got Joe Thomas. Flippy. think I might send him to Buffalo. Head to Buffalo. Maybe? Nope. Wow, I was really indecisive with this one. Gotta get the best value for your best player. I don't know why I accepted that one, looking back on it. Yeah, well. Next one. JC, who we getting? And like I said earlier, man, the whole idea behind this was just getting picks. I wanted to get as many picks as possible. And maybe find a way to flip and move. I think I ended up with 4 first round picks this year. And still couldn't find a quarterback. Yeah, man, this one, flipping the line, because quite frankly, if we're going to lose 16 games, it doesn't really matter who's on the roster at this point. Well, that's all it really is to that. Taking the offer to the most picks. Once again. And Zeitler. Who did we get for Zeitler? I think it was Atlanta. Nope, San Francisco. That's a good pick. I mean, they're obvious what the Browns need to do. Man, they just blow it up and build it back up. Nothing noteworthy on the injury report. What about the NFC playoffs, though, man? Nick Foles and Case Keenum playing for a chance to go to the Super Bowl. I don't think anybody saw that one coming. Just a trip, man. More offers. Just flipping people. I said, man, most of these I end up just taking picks. Most, if not all of them, there's trades or picks. Trying to get as many picks as possible from it. Gotta build through draft. Very few teams in the league can actually build through free agency. Just hard. You know, there's not enough money to go around. And, you know, like, the whole, like, point and, like, premise is, like, realistic rebuilds. So, I want to do it. Not sure this is going to be possible, you know. Dr. Shrimp Puerto Rico is going to come in and just blow it up, you know. And we're going to find the best way to bring the team back up from the ashes. We're going to have some fun with it. I've already played a few games, and it's a challenge, but it's enjoyable. For sure. And looking back on this, I really hope they don't copyright me because of the music in the background. That would just be super shitty. Hey man, welcome to the channel. That's your first view. Y'all wouldn't mind. Let me get a like. Let me get some subs, you know. That'd be dope. Post a lot of videos, you know. Big into sports games. I'm starting to post my Call of Duty stuff. Campaigns, walkthroughs, my players, you name it. Pretty much have done it all. I'm planning on doing it all. Just feel free to request something, man. If y'all want to see something, I had a kid request a Road to Glory player. I'm having fun doing it, man. So, like I said, just feel free, and we'll probably find a way to knock it out. Y'all might ask me, why are you trading Isaiah Crowell? I'm not gonna win anyway, so why not flip them, man? Gotta get them picks. The way I look at it is, sorry, I got distracted by it. Keep going Instagram. Now, the way I look at it is, if you know, y'all were worth anything, probably would have already won with you on the team. But, speaking of the Browns and their just terrible approach to winning,
anything. I heard they're trying that whole Moneyball thing, which makes no sense. The whole premise of the rebuild was to put everything in place and get a quarterback last, I guess, so they could, you know, just put him in and he'd play well and it would all be good and nice and smooth. I.e. Derek Carr came to a good situation with a lot of talent around. That being said, really didn't work out well for Derek Carr this year. Just didn't really seem to do anything for the Browns anyway. I mean, anybody, if you got a decent quarterback, you probably win a few games. But they're getting better though, man. They got some position players. They got some skill. Josh Gordon seems to be the real deal again. You know, so that's hope he does well, man. I'm pulling for him. He seems to beat his demons, which is, you know, knock on wood, most important thing for him. Let's look at like the real draft though, man. I think there's no way if you're the Brown would you let Barkley go. She's, I mean, if you think about it, man, the quarterbacks are kind of hit or miss. Running backs are probably a lot less. Especially they're looking at drafting somebody like Josh Allen, which I think might be an appeal they take. Don't know, I think I love Josh Allen. Personally, I'm a Steelers fan. I would love for him to sit behind Ben for a few years. I just don't. You can't, if you're Brown, you can't draft him and not put a running back like Barkley with him. It would not end well. It would be rough. But, oh, free agent time. I signed a Gronkowski. I want to get a veteran back up in here. Maybe have him start and just see what happens, but I don't think I found anybody. Running backs. Scrolling with everybody. I'm pretty sure I should have signed Tariq, but kind of figured he would actually be on the roster at some point. Once I sent through all the misery of the Browns losing, I was wrong. I don't think I signed many. Corey Grant's also a silly. Dude's got wheels. I think I signed Shoelace Robinson. I think that's who I ended up going with. Don't 100% quote me on that, but trying to focus on speed. I like speed. At least in Madden, speed is the winner. If you have speed, you can cut, you can move, you can find a way to make a win in Madden. That's the way I look at it anyway. I really did not realize I spent this much damn time trying to find a fucking backup running back. Actually, I think I might have ended up starting him the more I look at it. Yeah. Gave Shoelace that contract. Thought he was so good in college, and he was the fucking game changer, man. Yep. Signed Gronkowski. One. Well, several reasons. One, he's got a product called the Ice Shaker, which, go check that shit out if you haven't already. It's the best shaker bottle I've ever had. Nothing sticks, doesn't smell. Once you wash it out, the taste doesn't stay. And, well, I signed him so I could throw that Gronk hashtag in the tag, so hopefully get some more views. That would be ideal. I think I signed Still. Yeah, signed Still right quick. Looking back on it, if I'm force tossing, and sign up, check out Still's like Instagram, man. Super inspirational. But, man, I figured if I'm gonna force toss all this shit, I'm not really sure why I actually spent so much time trying to fucking find people to put in. Sinquist. I'm pretty sure I signed Sinquist. He was supposed to be a stud when Steelers drafted him. Just couldn't fucking stay on the field. Yeah, that's so pricey for a guy who hasn't played a damn snap in the NFL yet. Let's see what else I'm gonna do. I think there's one more move that I'm about to make. Yeah, that's what it is. I went to high school with this dude, you know, so shout out to him. Had to get him on the roster. And then, yeah, man, I don't think I signed a safety or nothing like that. Alrighty, y'all. That's it, man. Check back for the next video ASAP.